Hi guys, this is Benny.
And this is Drew. And today we will review the trailer of Your Excellency. Okay, so if I look at the IMDb of this trailer, it says the movie entails generally on the West African country, Nigeria, which is about to conduct an election for the 13th democratic president of the country. It entails about the happenings in the country's political sector and the country at large during the general elections.
Okay, so another political drama, it seems.
Yes. Okay.
I love Obama, he loves Donald Trump, and together we are going to make Nigeria great again.
All you have to do is say yes, then fund the campaign. She kidding.
Are you serious?
If you become the president, you gotta talk to me. I'll just dash him on your pad.
Which money are you dancing? Government money.
Michael Idehe, you should know my husband, the dancer.
Your campaign should be handled by seasoned hand.
I was just trying to give him my opinion about you.
What? You? Let the glory of the first lady who's all over me.
Jehovah. Mimo.
We have to get a pastor that have the email address of God.
God has email nowadays.
The caterpillar of winning.
It's going to be an election like no other before it.
You have tried three times and you have failed.
If Donald Trump can do it, so can I.
And it is time for my generation to return this country to glory.
I hope that you are not lazy.
Lazy Nigeria, you.
I just happened to be single. Are you saying that you are not romantically involved with any of these women?
No.
You just can't help being a boy sometimes.
Your girlfriend tried chucks me, but...
Cut!
I don't...
Is that it? That is it.
This is my wife.
Candy. You look even bigger in real life.
Hey, you have packed out your red night. You do all that I like.
Well, hello, dear husband.
Sheshiri.
You know what?
I will beat you black.
All right.
Well, in the beginning, I couldn't much get what the flow was. I mean, in what direction it is going. But it does seem like it's a feud between a young politician and a senior politician. And, you know, where the guy says it's time for my generation to be in politics, to win the case or something, you know. So it seems to be a generation thing between two politicians of different generations. And of course, then there's this, the wife and maybe some mistress. And what I've seen in Nigerian movies is that every drama is taken with a bit of humor. You know, what are actually supposed to be very, troublesome circumstances, they take it in a funny manner. And one thing I feel is that, you know, Nigeria, I mean, from what movie trailers we have seen so far, politics does seem to be a very important aspect of their daily life. You know, whatever trailers we've seen so far, somewhere or the other, it is connected to politics. Even Love is War, even that one was about politics. Even Chief Daddy was that or not, but somewhere or the other, we can see the influence of politics through in various Nigerian movies.
Yeah, and I wonder if, I mean, again, this is a comedy, which is like, you know, it's a politics is a heavy subject. Again, it is dealt with comedy, which is fascinating. But I also hope that the makers have some kind of a message in it. Like, you can do that in comedies as well. It doesn't have to be all slapstick and all just giggles. It can be like, maybe this is how we should approach this, you know, something like that. Maybe the younger guy they showed, I feel like it, I got the sense, now we would have to watch the movie to know for sure, but I got the sense that he was really into this. He was really into, he was serious about the position he was fighting for, whereas the older guy had just this fascination about, he was starstruck by the idea of, you know, getting that position. So then eventually what happens in the movie itself, like, would be interesting to see who wins it. Does the older guy win it, or does the younger guy win it? In most cases, in at least in other countries, older people get more of a chance for a position as opposed to younger people. And I hope that this movie helps you question that, you know, whether should it be based on age? Of course, with age comes some experience, but age in itself is not, you know, is not everything. Experience in itself is not everything. Aptitude also matters. Like, this is the dilemma we have had in the tech sector as well. Like, they're like, do you give promotions based on tenure? If somebody has been there for 10 years, are you going to give him a promotion, or are you going to objectively look at new talent who has performed really outstandingly in the few years that they have been here, maybe 2 or 3 years, and give them that promotion? That's very important for youngsters to go into new companies. So I would be interested in seeing what happens in this movie, and what is the general with age in terms of politics.
Yeah, so you can see where one time the older guy, he says, you know, you can't help being a boy. So he's like, just trying to put him down just because he's the younger fellow, you know, and he's just trying to pull his weight because he's the more experienced and the elder fellow. And, you know, did you notice that there was another guy who was all the time taking videos of whatever family drama was going on? Did you notice that?
Yeah.
He was taking videos when the wife catches him doing something, and when they're having a row or something. Each time he's taking a video. I think that's kind of going to be a catch in the story, and that's going to be, you know, one of the things where there will be a twist in the plot because of those things. It seems to me like that.
Yeah, I wonder if he's that kind of a journalist where, you know, they, in certain movies I've seen, and I suppose that happens in real life as well, there is that journalist who kind of wins your trust, that, you know, I'm going to write an awesome story about you. Let me follow you around. Let me shadow you to see what your life is like. And I'm just going to present you in a great light. And that way you can maybe win the election or get more voters. But then he actually might end up doing something else completely, and might, you know, frame you for something. Like, but he was all over the place. He was also with the older guy and the younger guy. And you know, that would be interesting to see, because all of this, like politics, journalism, all of that works together. And politics is a ruthless game. There is no other, there is no other profession where I see that there are just no limits, like anything goes, you know? So
anything.
Yeah, there are no rules. Like, it is, even like, I've seen interviews of politicians who are like attacked on a personal level, like someone is maligning their image and they're like, what do you feel about it? Like, I don't take it personally. Like, you know, it's just accepted that anything goes and you can do anything. So I wonder what the role of the journalist is, and I really wonder what happens towards the end. I mean, of course, the journey is important, but like, to me, from the trailer, it seemed like the younger guy was more passionate about the role itself, and the older guy was just starstruck about like being in power.
Yeah, it's like it was he behaved as if he was the one who's going to win it anyways, and he's the only one who deserves to win it, you know, just because he has done it before and because the other guy is a younger guy. It's like it's taken for granted by him, and that's why you can see he's just partying and then just, you know, dwelling in the power and everything.
And he's not even taking it seriously. Like you could see the younger guy was kind of serious and the older guy was just like, ha ha ha, you're fired. Like he's maybe just doing that just because he idolizes Donald Trump and he wants to follow in his footsteps. Like, I want to be like him. So that's why he's into this. He's not really into, it seems like he's not really into politics for the real deal. He's into it because he wants to be like Donald Trump and he looks up to him. Did you notice that the main character and his first lady, the lady was practicing to be first lady, was not actually his wife, that his wife was someone else?
Yes. Oh my God.
And did you see that for the younger guy, the guy who was the younger candidate, there was this really gorgeous woman who went to his plane and bribed someone to take her pictures in his plane. And I suppose it was the opposite party trying to frame him to be a womanizer.
Yes, just because he's young, so he would be a womanizer. Oh God. Trying to portray him as a playboy or something.
Right. And that's all fair in politics, right? Like, and the irony is he was not a womanizer. The older guy was the womanizer.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
But people would think that he's young and he's good looking, so he should be the womanizer. Like, you know, feeding into those preconceived notions and playing with people's psychology is all fair game.
Yeah, and here you get a good idea of how media plays a very important role in politics, because what they portray is what you are. Basically, at the end of the day, it's what you are portrayed that is what you are going to stand out to the public to be.
Right,
and you also depend on that.
Yeah, and this also begs the question of media integrity. Like, you know, but the thing is, whoever pays the most money wins. So who knows, like, what happens? Yeah. Like if that really tarnishes the younger guy's image or not. And did you see that younger reporter, reporter was asking him, so are those rumors correct or true? And he's like, no, I'm single. And she was like, huh, great.
Yes.
Was hitting on him, not because she wanted to know the truth, but because she was interested in him, which is funny.
Yeah.
Hopefully we understand everything that's going on. It's a little hard to gauge from the trailer. It's hard to gauge all the humor that comes in, but from what I picked up, anything political, is interesting because it gives you the idea, it gives you more knowledge about a country and what the people think about the approach in politics. Do the movies talk about, you know, this shouldn't be this way, can it be done this way? Those are great movies, whether it's a comedy or a drama or whatever, or a thriller or whatever.
Yeah. Something that comes to my mind is, you know, the more trouble that you go through, the easier it comes to take it along, you know? It's like if you're always facing some trouble or the other, it's like you're like, okay, this happens, go on, laugh about it, you know? And like in Western culture, it seems that things are taken much more seriously and people would rather make a serious movie out of it with some action probably, and a lot of tension and pressure and stress, whereas what you see in Nigerian movies, all such things where there's a high level of stress, you take it with fun. Right. I love that about that.
I think it's kind of like how, at least when I traveled to Mexico and I saw that, you know, there are a lot of problems in Mexico, and I mean there are a lot of problems everywhere, but Mexico has its problems, and yet that doesn't bring the people down. I think it's about the culture, and that culture is a celebratory culture, and I would think that Nigerian culture is also celebratory. Every trailer we saw, whether it was a funeral, whether it was an election, whether it was a fight, everybody at some point was dancing. And what stands out to me is how amazing their dressing sense is. That is real fashion to me. Like the kind of clothes they were, I'm in awe of that. Like just absolutely gorgeous clothing, you know? And I don't understand like why people don't talk about it enough. Like, the more I, even in the trailers, I'm just blown away by the clothing and the dance and the celebrations. It just feels like it's alive.
It's full of life. You like, know, it's full of life.
It's life. There is a carnival. That's what it feels like. If you live there, it's a carnival. You are not going to take yourself seriously. Problems come and you'll be like, okay, you know?
Yeah.
Let's laugh about it. All right, guys. So if you liked our video, please go ahead and actually like it and subscribe to our channel. Hit that bell icon to get notified and leave us a comment and let us know how we're doing, what you would like us to review. And if you like our video, then also share it with friends. Please get the word out. Until next time, Firmilenge.
Firmilenge. See you. Bye, guys.